why. Celebrity rooftop, I got sweet me, why. Why, just a sweet me. It's your girl, Macka Dimond. I'm going to say your celebrity rooftop to the world. Keep it locked and change the dial. It's like a comma,
Welcome to Celebrity Rooftop. I'm your host, Black Barbie, and I'm here with the internationally known, the one and only, as she said, Miss Moneyo, the one and only Macka Dimond. Look how she looking all fab. Loving the ear style right now. Macka Dimond, how you doing?
Thank you. My head was all swelling. I mean, international. Wow. I love that. Thanks, you know.
But of course, you're internationally known all over the world. Oh my gosh. Of course, you're a great writer, plus an artist, entrepreneur. You're doing your thing. We're loving it. And I must say, for 2014, I've been a wonderful year for Macka. How you feel?
It's wonderful, and it's getting even great and greater, you know, because I mean, there were times when I work and I'm like, what am I working for? I'm gonna give up. But when you see it pays off, you know. So once you work, and I'm seeing it in 2014, and it is so wonderful, and I'm giving thanks, you know, to all the supporters. And I'm gonna thank God to give me the strength to keep continuing also, you know.
Yes, definitely. And we know, say, you have a big fan base over there in Europe. I mean, you've been over there. Tell us a little bit about, you know, the scene on that side of the world.
It's great. I mean, we've been to Paris, Switzerland, Germany, and it was great. The people accepted me well, and they were, you know, what was so surprising about the Europe market was, like, there were songs that they're not even think are here, like, you do those songs and forget them, and they were the songs that were big songs. So I had to be lip singing or singing those songs or studying for the night, that people like, you have to sing this song, you know. And it was fun, it was great. They were fanatic. Right.
And of course, you've been in this industry for a very long time. You have numerous hits. And like you say, sometimes you have to lip sync to remember all the hits that you actually have. I mean, what's your most memorable show that you have done thus far?
My most memorable? Out of all, from a career to come until now?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I would say one of my favorite ones was definitely the Sumfest in Jamaica when I came on the money suit. And that is always memorable to me, because people everywhere I go, people still ask me, where's that money outfit? Where? I think I've made a mark. And for artists, usually when your career just take off in Jamaica and you go on a big show like that, they put it to work early, like between 7 and 9 p.m. in the night. That's when a lot of people are not really there. Yeah. So what was so special about this show, I'm going to work between 9 to 9:30. And I was like, the venue is empty, but you see, when I walk up with that money suit, it's like people who have not reached there yet, everybody heard, and it was, I think I've made a mark, and that's what made it very special that night for me, that Sumfest. I think it was 2002 or one of them year.
Nice. So being that you're a female in this industry for such a long time, and it's so hard for a female that's coming up to make it this big and be on the platform that you are on right now, what advice would you even give to a female artist in the business? So they can't just keep them head straight. Cause you know how the men are. Because this is like a man-dominated industry. And we have to stand up for ourselves, yes?
And as I always say, whether we like it or not, we don't want to see these bag of females coming up. It is still male-dominating. We have not conquered it as yet. But the only advice I have to give them is, have to love it from your heart. You have to just keep trying and stay focused, you know, because it is attacking. It is very attacking and feels dangerous at times, but you have to stay focused. That is definitely what I have to tell them. Focus is the key.
True. So only here, only take notes and listen to Macka, because she know what she's talking about. Because you see, she's been in the industry for this long and she's still there, dip on top. And of course, doing your thing, your single, Die, oh my gosh.
Yeah, great. And Die seems like, oh my God. What is this song? Why when I go and I'm trying to promote Karma on the next song, or Bigfoot, they're like, Die. Well, I said, hello. But I'm grateful, and it's still traveling. And I'm heading to the East Coast soon, where I'm going to be doing some tours. And I'm really, Louisiana and some weird name place I'm hearing about now. So, and this is because of Dada, you know. I mean, a lot of people know Bonim and the other songs that I've done already and stuff. But I think Dada have kicked down some different doors, and some doors that is officially say, Macka, you are in the business. It's your work. You work for this. So congrats. You know, that's what Dada is telling me right now.
Yes, it's big, everybody love it. I mean, every girl I wind up jiggly, including me, because I love the track. And of course, you know, speaking on your single, the latest that dropped from Macka, of course, Karma, the video, The video is so sick. You guys definitely have to go on YouTube and check it out because it's mad. But, you know, before we even get to the video, there was a little controversy because we know Macka to be controversial at times. Of course, when Die Die dropped, everybody has said, whoa, you know why, that picture.
Right.
Now there's a different picture that actually dropped with Karma, and we never see this clip in the video. I mean, was this an accidental, you know, picture, or was it planned?
It was. I mean, it wasn't supposed to be out. That's definitely accidental, but it was there. I mean, as I said, you sometimes you're parried people, and you have people around here, you can't trust them. So we never knew, and we don't know up to now who has really leaked it. And we were trying to put there a certain part of the video. You know, when I do video, I like to do X-rated and the clean version and really, so you know, stuff like that. And that was just one of them. As I said, people in the paper said that, I said that it was a romantic moment. Or yes, I'm acting. That's my play. That's my role in my video shoot. So that was the romantic part of it. You know, that was a romantic moment. Mm-hmm. And but you know, things get hectic. Things got I don't know what happened. I mean, I was on the set, and I made sure I asked Major, is everything okay? You have this. Every time I shoot video with people, I'm live mashup on it.
Yes, because
I said that to him, and he said, everything is okay. And then, boom, there appear things. But at the end of the day, we just decided that to put the video out clean. A lot of people upset them, feel like, oh, the video should have this and that. But mm-hmm. I said, okay, to make life easier. You know, we don't want mashup nobody live, so. Mm-hmm. You know, and we want them to say, this is all a video shoot. This is just a video shoot, and there's music. It's music.
But you know, sir, mm-hmm. thing got circulated. Not me, that's a major life mashup still. So, of course, you know, the baby mom don't want to take him back and all that thing.
Wow.
Based on just the picture, so I guess if we actually see the video, the next thing.
What would have happened? Yes. Because if we decided to send it out clean and she's still gone, I don't know. Maybe she thinks something else. I don't know. Yeah. I can't say. Well, maybe we should find out that from Major.
For real. And like Major said, because he made his plea, it's all in the industry. That's just a part of his job. And like you hear Macka say, it just leak a little, but we're not going to bother that right now.
Right.
Yes, girl, big things are going. So, of course, with this video, Karma, that's out, the single that dropped just a month ago, it's doing really, really well because we heard to bust up in a Jamaica on Wednesday and things.
It's crazy. And I've gotten a lot of feedback from the selectors and the radio disc jocks back home and even Florida, you know. So we don't know them things that stay. Once you're doing music, it's going to stay till it creep and take it time and develop into all various places. But I think Karma, it is a slow bomb, but it's going to explode soon. Mm-hmm. Definitely.
And of course, you know, after the video Karma on the video shoot, we see the ear color change. So tell us a little bit about that reason, man.
Because I mean, I've seen other people wearing colored ear for years. And I mean, I said, I'm going to change my look, put out my green ear. And then when I went back to Jamaica, it's like the whole of Jamaica saying, okay, I love it, Macka. I don't care, we're going to wear it. And they're wearing it. So, which is good to be a leader. And I'm good with that. And I seen, you know, so I said, okay, I'm going to change a little bit from the cut off short back and go into a full house, and let's see, maybe they're gonna love it too.
Yes, and I'm not gonna tell no lie, I really, really love this hairstyle on you. I love the color. Come and say a mixture of the color before, prior. Because if you guys follow Macka, you guys know, make sure you follow up on Instagram, all right?
Like
Ever Funny.
My son said to tell him to follow me. Macka Dimond 1.
So follow. But I must say, it definitely suits you well. It looks really, really good on you. And being in the industry for this long, we are follow you, cause you don't know where I'm from. Ula, oop, there's a long, long, long time.
I'm for stop DJ now, this, that.
And we don't want that.
I mean, people keep good and feel good as you are. It doesn't matter. You just keep doing this. My career, I treat this as a job. So until I feel like I can't do no more or whatever, I'm not going to be letting people get rid of me. You know, I mean, if I should stop DJ, who is running the place, who is doing nothing? So it's not like there's somebody there and I'm trying to take their space and I'm trying to interrupt them. I'm just doing me and just doing me and loving me for me and just give thanks for what God has blessed me. Because there's a lot of people, there's a lot of male and female that really don't even reach half as where I'm at, you know. And I have to appreciate it and give thanks and just be humble about it. And you know, say, Father God, you bless me. I wouldn't have to overdo it when the time is time for me to retire. I'm retired, you know. That's it. But I mean, everybody like, Macka, there's no retirement. We love you, Ray, and whatever. And I think Bonim done already, and Die Die that is what people not gonna give up. They're still gonna even want me to, even my old friends them, when I'm gray and whatever they wanna say, they wanna want me to come somewhere, mm-hmm. if even to a bar and sing it, die, die, whatever. And have fun, you know. So it's just life. You have one life to live, let's live it. Let's all live it, you know?
True, true. And I totally agree with that. And I must say, black definitely don't crack, because me don't know what Macka Dimond do. No, I know the secret. What's the secret to this youthful look? Because
Worry about it. That's it. Don't worry. Yeah, don't get up and say, oh, I'm getting old. I have a sister in Arizona. She called me when she was 40 and she was like, I'm getting old. And she was crying like, shut the hell up. You're getting younger. I mean, just, I don't worry about it. It's only when people mention age that I really think about age. It's like, I just live, you know, and that's it, you know. And I have my good friends and I keep in touch with, and they're always there, and they want to know too, because sometimes I see some of my friends and I'm like, hello. Or me or some people I go to school with, I'm like, oh.
All them looks up.
Yeah. But it's like, I don't know, I think it's a blessing too, and I don't worry, I don't think about it. As for me, age is just a number. I'm just living my life. Just like when I started to know myself as a teenager and started to take care of myself, and I can buy my own clothes, do my hair. That's how I feel, same way. A lot of people don't understand it. When they get to this age, it doesn't bother you. You're gonna get there one day and you're gonna see that it is no different. It is just a number. When you get up there, you're gonna act a little bit more mature, you're gonna do certain things different. But at the end of the day, it doesn't feel any way. It's a stage, you know, of your life, just like you're growing your kids, you know. Your kids at this age, and they have to recognize that, yeah, everybody have to get old, and everybody's going to be young one day and old one day. And you just live, you know.
Nice, nice. I want to make sure, so I need to advise. Make a choice, stop worrying, because me just celebrate a birthday, and boy, me that cringe.
No,
I was cringing.
No. Don't worry.
I was like, oh God, I'm so old.
Well,
now.
Remember, them said, they're saying Macka is old, Macka this, and one video shoot mashup live. I mean, you still have something. Whatever.
Things I want, that's how I like it.
So that's why age is nothing.
Definitely not. Because of course, Macka, you definitely don't look your age. You look really, really young. And like I'm saying, because I'm even sitting up close and personal, I look on her, I look on her skin, her face. Yes. Black don't crack at all. There's no crack in there. She's looking fabulous. Yes. Yeah. Yes, video one. Double close up so you can see the pretty face. Yes, I go on with things.
You know, I would say, we, you know, so it's right now, me circling the U.S. We just did Philadelphia, Chicago. My tour was started last month in July, but because of the permit, the schedule I got at the embassy, it was a little bit behind time, so a lot of shows had to cancel. So after I do New York and the little holiday, Labor Day weekend, I'm going to California next weekend, and we'll do California, then we'll do St. Louis, come back and do some south side, some east coast, sorry, mm-hmm. For 3 nights, Louisiana, some couple weird places, I can't even remember them now, and then I go Canada on tour. I'm going on September mountain, Canada, we're going straight, and then to Atlanta after that. So it's a whole heap. So right now, I gotta have to get my beauty nap, my rest is, and you know, yeah. Do my push-ups.
Push-ups, why? Get ready, of course, for that big, big tour that you're about to do right now. So let's talk about, you know, your single. We know Karma, you're pushing right now. Are you actually working on an EP or an album so the fans them can actually look
yes,
out for
I'm
it?
I'm definitely going to be working on my album. And for some reason, my album is definitely going to be a one-drop album. Yes, and I won't be releasing until next summer, because I'm going to take my time and, you know, take a good 3 months. Right after the October, and those, you know, I mean, even in December, January, February, you know, getting everything together, and definitely it's gonna be a one drop. I'm gonna go straight one drop.
But you know, your fans them are be curious, because we know you for the dancehall people, and we know you for the party.
Them have it, it's them. There's already they have it. So I think something new and different for me would be great. So I'm really I've planned it and planned who I really want to share songs with, who I want to do combinations with. I have all of those in my head already, plans and stuff like that, and I've already reached out to a couple of people and they are ready. Mm-hmm. So you know, and this album is going to be all produced by me. I'm gonna you know, get it done, mm-hmm. the proper way, and ready.
So you say you're working on a few collabs.
Yeah, I'm going to definitely do that because you don't know. There's a lot of one-drop artists that I'm fond of, and I'm going to be, you know, those are the surprises I'm going to give people. Like, I'm going to be working with that person very, very eventually, and I can't wait, you know. And it's going to be, I know it's going to be fun, and it's going to, there's some hit going to come out of it.
Some big thing. Definitely. So you don't know, say, for you, she smile like that is some big thing I'm going to go on. So, of course, you know, let's talk about your book because we know you're a great, terrific writer. When is the next book?
Oh, gosh, that is what I'm saying. I think the book thing is going to be a little put off until the album because I'm going to stay focused on the album. And since I've already done 4 books and I'm still promoting the last one, The Naughty and Nice, which I'm going to be in, you know, a lot of the venues that I turn up in with for the shows, I sell and sign a couple of them. So, you know, so like the fans can look out for me, you know, in their tri-state area. And I'm going to be in New York, a lot of these couple places, signing up. So they'll be seeing me. But the book is great, great, great. And I'm going to be doing, I know I'm going to be doing another book, but I think it's after the album.
Oh boy, I'm not coming out in a lie. You're busy. She got a lot that's going on.
If you're not busy, the bills won't pay.
I like that. But like I said, I'm here with internationally known, the one and only Money O Queen, the one and only Macka Dimond. So make sure that you guys look out for her in a city near you. You hear the EP is going to be one drop. Yes, something different, right. A different style from the one and only Macka. And like we said, we got it here for you guys at Celebrity Rooftop. So I want you guys to just keep it where you have it. We'll be right back.